Hey, I'm Lottie. I hope you don't mind if I carry on cooking while we have a quick chat. So, check out what I found the other day. That was outside a house down the road, where the path should be. And this was inside. Ugh, it stinks! It's gross to think that everything that goes down the toilet could come up through the downstairs shower plug hole. But what causes it? How does it happen? Let's take a look. Don't you just love burgers? But what do you do with all the fat and the oil? Some people just pour it down the sink. Honestly. And why not scrape your plates down there too? You know, little bits of salad, rice, chocolate cake. No problem. My friend says, if you put hot soapy water down there, it washes it all away. But it won't. It'll only make it gloopier and cause more blockages. Look.
Oil and water don't mix. So as the fat and oil travels down from the sink, it cools and eventually begins to harden on the roof of the pipe. Then food waste and fats mix with stuff people put down the toilet, and layer by layer this disgusting mess blocks the pipe.
But it's not just your problem or my problem. It's everybody's problem because we're all connected. Pipes from your house will join up with pipes from your neighbours and they run into a bigger sewer, and shops and factory sewers join up with them. And then everybody in town joins into the same sewer network. Can you imagine if all the cafes, chippies and restaurants poured their fat down the sewer? Well, let's take a look. This is footage from a real sewer, and that's real fat and rotting food and stuff which shouldn't be down there. In such big lumps, they're called fatbergs, and they cause thousands of blockages every year. Sewers are just like arteries. If there's a blockage, then there's a major problem. So teams are on standby 24/7 to get rid of any stinky stuff. So guys, what seems to be the problem?
Well, we've had one of our customers call in complaining they can't use their toilets.
And it is pretty horrible down there too.
Yeah, it's a main sewer, so everyone comes in here. It's just a case of it's too thick to flow through.
So what's in there?
As you can see, that's all grease, and there's also a lot of wipes in there, baby wipes, face wipes, stuff like that.
Basically just everything we class as non-flushables that shouldn't be going down the sewers.
It's so stinky. So what should a clean one look like?
Well, we've got one downstream if you'd like to have a look.
So that's how it should look. What a difference. With the east of England being so flat, there's hundreds of pumping stations like this to keep the used water flowing to the water recycling centres. Now, if a pump gets blocked, then everyone whose pipes are connected could have problems flushing their toilets. And if it overflows, then we could get sewage on our streets or in rivers. So that's why people like Shane and Neil are always keeping an eye on things. Pumps are really heavy to lift out. It could take two people several hours. It's not a nice job, but somebody's got to do it. Or maybe in future they won't have to, if we learn how to prevent it. Oh, and I've got some more gross facts for you.
A fatberg has been discovered the size of a double-decker bus. There's enough fat, oil and grease in Anglian Water's pipes to fill 8 Olympic swimming pools. Anglian Water's teams deal with a pipe blockage almost every 15 minutes, 24/7. If you stacked all the full waste skips that Anglian Water have to send to landfill each year on top of each other, they would be almost as high as Mount Everest.
So you might be wondering why I've brought you in here. Well, you know what that is. And you know what some people put down it? Things like cotton buds, cotton wool, hair, floss, and all kinds of wipes. Baby wipes, face wipes, cleaning wipes, you know what wipes. And some people wonder why it gets blocked. That's where it should go. Wipes are a real problem. Even if the label says that they can flush, they don't break down like loo roll. And when they're wet, they're really strong.
As those wipes and the used water from our sinks and toilets flow towards the water recycling centre, they mix with the fats, oil and grease and all the other items, which blocks up the pumps.
So here at the Water Recycling Centre, they use giant screens and filters to sift through all kinds of rubbish. Things like mobile phones, keys, even false teeth. You would be amazed. Oh, it's horrible. So they chop it up and dry it out. And when it looks like this, it's ready to take to a rubbish tip. All of that when you could have just thrown your rubbish away in a bin at home, saving the problems, expense, and environmental pollution. On average, Anglian Water clear about 30,000 blockages a year, and over half of those are caused by things like fat and grease mixing with other stuff like wipes, which we chuck away without thinking. So I've come up with a slogan about keeping pipes clear. If it hasn't been through you, don't flush it down the loo. Oh, and loo roll. I probably wouldn't eat that. I'll come up with a better slogan. Anyway, bye.